20 important map locations for India. The first is at Udupi, we have the St. Mary Island. Now, this is an island where which has one of the geoconservation sites that have been found. And the idea is the volcanic rhyolite lava has seen columnar joints that have been seen in the St. Mary Island in Udupi in Karnataka. So, this was part of the August Down to Earth edition. The next is the Pong Dam. Now, Pong Dam lies in Himachal Pradesh. Under mysterious circumstances, there were serious number of bird deaths that were found as part of the spread of the bird flu across India, and 95% of those were the bar-headed geese, which were migrating from Siberia and Mongolia. So nearly more than 1 lakh birds migrate every year during the winters to the Pong Dam region in Himachal Pradesh. This time there had been huge number of deaths that have been found, and that was because of the virus being brought by the Siberian strain or the migratory birds. Now, the samples had been sent for investigation to two important labs. Where they are situated is again important. So, one is in Bhopal, which is the High Security Animal Disease Laboratory, HSADL. Now, this is one of the major laboratories in India, the only major laboratory which tests the bird flu samples. Then we also have another institute which is in Jalandhar, the Northern Regional Disease Diagnostic Laboratory, and that is based in Jalandhar in Punjab. So those are the two important laboratories. Besides that, the Indian Veterinary Institute at Bareilly in Uttar Pradesh is another important location. The next is Deporbil. Now Deporbil is one of the major regions of Guwahati. Numerous fishing communities organize the Magh Bihu, the Bhogali Bihu in this region, and mass fishing is seen during the Bihu festival. Now this was also designated as the 2002 Ramsar Convention site. Ramsar sites are the sites which are protected under the wetland conservation, and the idea is to protect the aquatic life of the region. So wetland, as a wetland, this has been very, very important. Deporbil, an important region of Assam, Guwahati. The next is Satkosia Tiger Reserve. Now Satkosia Tiger Reserve is seen is found in the region of Angul district, Odisha. This is where the Mahanadi river actually crosses or flows through. A mixed vegetation is commonly seen. Sal trees are the common trees that are seen here, and this wildlife sanctuary was created back in 1976. Recently in 2007, this has been given the status as a tiger reserve. So from a wildlife sanctuary to a tiger reserve, Satkosia is a very important location. The next is Omkareshwar Dam. It is one of the places on Narmada River where the world's largest floating solar power project would begin its operations in 2022. This is the Omkareshwar Dam is a gravity dam. You have numerous floating water floating panels that have been installed for solar power generation in the Omkareshwar Dam region, and there is a lot of development in terms of solar energy seen in the nearby areas as well. So Omkareshwar on Narmada is a very, very important location. It lies in the Khandwa district. The next is Sultanpur village. Now Sultanpur village is again a village where numerous water birds and migratory birds are seen every year. Again, we have seen a huge number of culling and bird flu that has spread mainly in the northern India this time. And the birds that have been affected mostly in the Sultanpur village in Gurgaon, close to Gurgaon, are the Siberian cranes, flamingos, Eurasian teal, then you have the northern pintail, wagtail, and the white and the yellow wagtail that have been very, very important. The next is Popampare. Popampare is one of the major districts in Arunachal Pradesh. The reason this has been in news is the vanadium that has been seen recently in the carbonaceous phaetic rocks that have been found here, both in the Tamang region and the Depo region of the Popampare district. Now, This is also known as stone coal, and the primary deposits have a good grade of vanadium that has been seen. Also, Poppanpare is the most populous district of Arunachal Pradesh. However, Arunachal Pradesh is the least the least densely populated state of India. So there is an interesting concept here. And here you also have the Itanagar Wildlife Sanctuary that is seen. The next is Sagar Island in West Bengal. The location is a confluence of Ganga and Bay of Bengal. And here we have the temple, which is the Kapil Muni temple, which has its whole historical basis. And it is also known as the Ganga Sagar. Also, the recent flow of Ganga, we have seen a lot of beaches that have been seen in the Sagar Island areas. The next is Dusko. Dusko Valley is an important border region between two states of Nagaland and Manipur. Now here we have the Puli Batse Wildlife Sanctuary, and many species which have been categorized under IUCN classification of vulnerable have been seen in this region. Some of the examples are hornbill, then we have dark rumped swift and similar other species that have been seen here. In terms of population, Angami tribe and Naga tribe are the two important tribes that are seen. The next is Phale village in the Ukhrul district in Manipur. Here we have seen the art of rearing the hornets, and this has been seen mainly by the Tangul Naga tribe, and a lot of hornets have been seen in the tree trunks, the hollow tree trunks that are there. The hornets are cultivated, and Urkhul is also known for its lily, the Shiru lily that is found here. Also, it is known for its caves and the Mangsor region that is present. The next is Mahananda Wildlife Sanctuary in Darjeeling. This is where the bird festival is celebrated every year, and this time we had the bird festival that was held recently in the month of February, and the two important birding spots are Rongdong and Latpanchor. The next is the Harik wetland. Now Harik wetland lies at the border of Taran Taran Sahib district and the Firozpur district. Lots of birds are seen here. Common teal, cormorants are some of the good examples. And besides that, we have lots and lots of migratory birds that are also witnessed. The next is Kyawali village in Budhwan district in Uttar Pradesh. Now, this is a district which is known for its Barewali sect of Muslims, where you have numerous martyrs have been seen. It was also the old capital of Delhi Sultanate, and it is also known as the City of Saints or Madinat ul Awliya. So those are the common names for the Budhwan city. The next is Anubhav Mantap, that is in the Bidar district in Karnataka. Now Bhasya Valkalyan is one of the major pilgrim centers for the Lingayat sect here, and it is known for the Bhasheswar, who was the 12th century poet, well renowned from this region, and the new Anubhav Mandap has been found in his respect. So very very important project in memory of Bhareshwar, who was one of the major poet and philosopher. The next is Pula village in West Godavari district in Arunachal Pradesh. The amount of nickel and lead in the blood samples of the people was very very high. The reason attributed to this was high use of organics, high use of pesticides and fertilizers in these areas, which have increased the amount of organochlorides in the drinking water, leading to numerous illness like epilepsy, convulsions, fever and so on, which has caused huge number of death in the region. The next is Haldwani in Nainital district. A new pollinator park has been developed where various species would be pollinated. Haldwani is known for its Haldu trees, which is one of the very very important deciduous trees of the Nainital region. It is mainly native to the region of South and Southeast Asia. The next is Tapi district in Gujarat. Here the Purna Wildlife Sanctuary is situated, and we have the Dang and the Nandurbar region of Maharashtra which lie close to it. The next is Kabardal wetlands, which lies in Begusarai district in Bihar. Now here There is an extensive floodplain complex that has been developed. Rashtrakavi Ramdhari Singh Dinkar was born at Begusarai. So again, Begusarai is important. And Kabartal wetland has been included recently as a part of Ramsar Convention as well. So again, a very important location. The next is Udupi, Wayanad and Coorg. All the three places have witnessed severe landslides, Coorg in Karnataka, Wayanad and Udupi in the regions of Kerala. So all the three regions have seen huge amount of construction activities, and that has speeded the process of the rapid landslides that have been seen in this region. The last is the Kundha Hydroelectric Power Scheme. Now, this is one of the major HEP generation power plants in Tamil Nadu, with more than 10 dams that has been established and kilometers of underground tunnels that have been developed. So, those are some of the important locations that have been in news recently. We would be covering many more important locations for you. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.